Yes. Class 9, good afternoon to you all. As we have read the chapter, Withering the Storm, it is complete, Ramneek, or it is left?
Ma'am, it is complete.
It is complete. Okay, finally. So, I hope that you have engrossed the story completely. You have understood that how Prashant, he has emerged out to be a leader. He has taken various steps in order to take hold of the situation. He has taken various steps, not only for the women, for the widows, but as far as that for young children also. So what he has done, first of all, he has started or he has put on a polythene sheet shelter in order to organize all the orphan children. Next, after that, he has organized some sports for these young children also, as he himself loved cricket a lot. So for that, after doing this, he also put women to work in Food for Work program, which is an initiative by an NGO. What is an NGO means? Non-government organization. So he has told the women to work in Food for Work program. Then when the government has come up forming separate institutions for women and for children, he did not welcome that idea. Why he did not welcome that idea? Because he thought that in these institutions, the women would be suffering from the stigma of loneliness, and moreover the children, they will be bereft of the love of the families. So what he has done, ultimately he has welcomed the idea of formulation of foster families, so that the children and the women can live in complete love or live with complete love of the families. So this is what Prashant has done. Okay, so half of the chapter, what it is related to, half of the chapter is related to the destruction which is caused by the super cycle. Where it has taken place? It has taken place in Orissa in 1919. And half of the chapter, lower part of the story, it is completely turned upwards. How? Because now Prashant, who was a sufferer at one point, he has emerged out to be a leader in the next one. See, this is the thing which he has done. So once the sufferer, then ultimately he has turned out to be the leader in the next part of the chapter. Okay, so it means that it's not only the situation that marks you, but if you have grit, if you have determination, you can overcome this kind of situation as well. The thing is that you have to find a key to the lock. And he has found a key to the lock. How he has found a key to the lock? That ultimately, how to overcome that situation. Okay. So he is concerned about the people of the village. This is what he has done. Right. So now, coming up to the discussion of the questions, answers of this chapter. So now, coming up to the question answers. First question is, what havoc has this super cyclone wreaked in the life of the people of Orissa? Yes. Speak. Yes, Ramneek. First of all, you can speak the answer.
Yes, ma'am. After the super cyclone, a raging, deadly brown sheet of water covered everything. Only some fractured cement houses still stood in a few places. Bloated animal carcasses and human corpses floated in every direction. Even the huge old trees had fallen. When Prashant went towards his village along with two friends of his uncle, the scenes they witnessed grew more and more horrid. They had to push away many human bodies and carcasses of dogs, goats and cattle. They could barely see a house standing. All the houses had been washed away.
Very good. So what havoc? The super cyclone has wrought a lot of destruction upon the area, as it has not only destroyed the houses but has also mutilated the life of the people. The people were of course the sufferers. All the houses, they have been badly devastated. Not a single house in Kalikuda village left erect. And then what happened? A brown sheet of water covered everywhere. There were dead bodies or animal carcasses as well as human corpses floating upon the water. For many days, the people did not have anything to eat. As for Prashant and his friend's family, what they were surviving only on raw coconuts. And when Prashant has reached Red Cross shelter, then it was for the first time that they had got rice, which was of course in its rotten phase. That was the first food that they have got. Okay, all the houses, 96 houses in the village, they have been broken down. Trees, larger trees have fallen upon the roofs of the houses, which has cracked the roofs, and or the belongings of the houses, they were mangled in the branches of the trees. Okay, so this you can also write down here. Fine.
Yes.
The next question is, how has Prashant, a teenager, been able to help the people of his village? Yes, Ashpreet, you can speak.
Yes, ma'am. Prashant, who was just 19 years old, decided to lead the people of his village. He organized a group of youths and elders to jointly pressurize the merchant once again to part with his rice. This task was done successfully. For the first time in 4 days, the survivors at the cyclone shelter were able to fill their bellies. Then he organized a team of youth volunteers and cleaned the shelter of filth, urine, vomit, and floating carcasses. And tended to the wounds and fractures of the people who had been injured by the cyclone. He brought the children who were orphaned together and put up a polythene sheet shelter for them.
Very good. Good points, which are absolutely related to the chapter. So now, let me recapitulate that how has Prashant, though a 19-year-old young boy, who has also suffered the destruction of super cyclone, but he has emerged out as a leader. How? He, while reaching the Red Cross shelter, sensitized the situation or felt the situation or felt the wretched condition of the people. Okay, he has taken solid steps, or he has taken some constructive steps in order to take the people out of the stigma of pain as well as suffering. The first and foremost thing that he did was to extract rice from the rice merchant who was not ready to part with his rice. Later on, when the rescue helicopter was hovering in the sky, he let some children lie onto the ground with empty utensils over their bellies to deliver the idea that they need food. Then the helicopters, they have thrown down some food and other valuables which are required for living. It was not only those steps. He has also understood the emotional needs of the suffering people. So first of all, he has organized a polythene, or he has constructed, or he has organized a polythene shelter for whom? For the orphan children, so that they can also get attention as well as food in proper ratio as to that of other families. In regard to the widows, he has put a concept to work for Food for Work program, which was started by an NGO. And in order to make children busy, he has also organized various kinds of sports matches, that of cricket, for the children and other people. Okay, so that they can come out of their pain of suffering. But this was not an end to this. When government has come up with an idea to organize or to establish separate institutions for both children as well as women. He did not welcome that idea. What he did, he put a question mark to it and came out with the idea to start foster families in which both the orphan children and the women will live together to foster each other so that there will be spread of love and affection among these lost families and the children will not suffer a lot. So this is how he has emerged out to be as a leader. It is actually not a short answer, it is complete in detail. Right? Next is, how have the people of the community helped one another? What role do the women of Kalikuda played during these days? Yes, Dia, it's your turn now. Yes, Dia, you can speak.
Yes, ma'am. The super cyclone had brought the havoc, wrecked the life of the people of Orissa. And the life of people was overtaken by a dark cloud of misery. But the people of the community got together and began to help one another under the leadership of young Prashant. Together, they pressurized the merchant to part with his rice for the people in the shelter. They gathered branches from fallen trees and lit a fire on which they cooked rice for all to eat. Then the military helicopter dropped some food parcel but did not return. The youth task force gathered empty utensils from the shelter and made the children lie in sand with the utensils on their stomachs to communicate to the passing helicopters that they were hungry. The message went through and the helicopter made regular rounds of the shelter, airdropping food and other basic needs. In every situation, women play a major role, and in this one too, women were mobilized to look after the orphans while the men secured food and materials for the shelter. Prashant had realized that the women too were grief-stricken and needed some work to be engaged. In spite of being grief-stricken, the women started working in the Food for Work program and started an NGO.
Very good. So women, what was the role do the women of Kalikuda play during these days? That women, they have also played a great role. Okay, so not only women were the sufferers, but ultimately they were working for Food for Work program. Moreover, when he has also come up with the idea of starting foster families where the widowed women, they will be taking care of the orphan children. So in this manner, what they are doing, they are ultimately playing a symbiotic role in which both of them, they were benefited. Okay, so women have also played a great role. Okay, so next question is, why do Prashant and other volunteers resist the plan to set up institutions for widows and orphans? Yes, Panika, you can speak now. Yes, Panika. Panika, you can speak. Some problem is there, Panika. I have unmuted you. Yes. Okay, fine. Then let me ask from somebody else. Ashpreet. Yes. Why to Prashant?
Yes, ma'am. Prashant and other volunteers resist the plan to set up institutions for orphans and widows because they felt that in such institutions, children would grow up without the love and widows would suffer from stigma and loneliness.
Very good.
They considered the alternative of resettling the orphans in their own community itself, possibly in new foster families made up for childless widows and children without adult care.
Yes. So what is the reason? It is because of the reason that the volunteers, Prashant was thinking that the volunteers, Prashant was thinking that this is not an optimum idea or this is not the right idea to set up separate institutions for widows as well as orphans. Because by organizing or by establishing these kind of institutions, what will happen that the children, they will suffer from the love, or they will be growing without the love of the families. They would not be under the, they would not be under the, you can say, protecting umbrella of the parents. So ultimately what will happen, they will not develop properly, and moreover the women, they will also suffer from loneliness as well as stigma of pain. So this is the reason why he did not welcome the idea of organizing separate institutions for orphans as well as widows. And what alternatives do they consider? So what alternative he has considered? He has come out with the idea to organize foster families, in which what will happen that that the, you can say that the women, they were, or the some foster families means they will adopt those widows, as other families will adopt those widows as well as children, so that they can live and grow with the love of the family. Okay, they will not suffer this kind of, you can say, separation from others. So it is because of this reason this idea was not welcomed by Prashant. And ultimately what has happened, that he has come up with the idea to start foster families. So the next question is, do you think Prashant is a good leader, or do you think young people can get together to help people during natural calamities? What do you think? Yes. Yes, who will speak? Do you think? Okay, let me explain. Yes. That Prashant, he has come out to be a good leader. No doubt that he has emerged out to be a good leader. As the entire story, it is about the valor, the positive efforts, constructive efforts, as well as that of the great ideas being presented by Prashant. He has taken the ship of the village from the storm of sufferings. Okay, it is just because of this reason that he was able to drive away those dark clouds which were lurking over the village, and ultimately being shattered, being broken, being down to the dumps, they were once again be ready to face the challenges of life. And it is none other than because of Prashant's efforts that he has put forward. So what he has done, Prashant, as a young leader, first of all, he has extracted rice from the village rice merchant, who was not ready to part with his rice. It is for the first time that in those 3 to 4 days, the people of the village, they had eaten rice. Otherwise, they were surviving on raw coconuts, and that was not the proper way to eat food. So after that, what has happened? He has also delivered the message to the helicopters that they also need food and other valuables which are required for life. And for that, what he has done, he has put the children lie onto the ground with their with empty utensils over their bellies so that they can have food to eat. He has also organized polythene sheet shelter for orphan children, where he organized them and provided them food and other basic necessities which are otherwise available to the people in the Red Cross shelter. Being not, you can say, discriminative on his part with his family, what he has done, he has organized various kind of matches like that of cricket, as he was too fond of, so that the people can enjoy, and even the children, or even the children will enjoy in this kind of, you can say, tough situation. He has also organized special, you can say, care to be taken for the women. He has also cleared up the area, Red Cross shelter, from the filth, from the urine, from the vomiting, and he has also cleared the place from as many animal carcasses as well as human corpses, they were floating over. So what he has done, he has taken care of the cleanliness as well as sanitation conditions of the area too. Moreover, he has inspired women to work in food for work program, so that while working, they will be made busy and they can get food, right? And then afterwards, when he has also came up with the idea to start foster families for widows as well as other children, as otherwise it is really very difficult for them to live in this kind of life where there will be loneliness, there will be suffering, there will be difficulties. Okay, so he is the one who has understood the emotional as well as the, you can say, emotional as well as the realistic needs of the people. So he has overcome with that idea that how to take care of them, right? So this is what he has done, and whatever the steps he has taken, they are no less than a leader. Only a leader can understand. Okay, only a leader can understand the people emotionally. Only a leader can understand the people in a better way. And this is what Prashant has done. Okay, so this is all about the textual questions of this chapter. And these textual questions you have to write down in your notebook. Okay, now some of the extra questions I would also like to discuss with you. For example, write down first question in your books pertaining to this part. Where Prashant has gone and why he had gone there? Where Prashant has gone and why he had gone there? So where Prashant has gone? Prashant has gone to his, where Prashant has gone?
Prashant had gone to his friend's house.
Why? In order to spend some quality time with his friend, as he has not seen his friend for a long time. And what happened? Okay, this next question I will tell you. He has gone to block headquarters of Arsama, which is a town in coastal Orissa, which was 18 kilometers away from his village. Okay. So, what horrible tragedy had befallen upon his life when he has gone to Arsama? What horrible tragedy had befallen his life when he had gone to Arsama? So what horrible tragedy has happened to him? So what horrible tragedy when he has gone to Arsama? The winds, strong winds were blowing in, at a very high speed, and what has happened? And that was just an indication of a super cyclone, and which engulfed entire Arsama and the adjoining areas on 27 October 1999. Okay, so dark clouds, it fills the entire area, and it rained for almost 3 days, or incessant rains for almost 3 days, and there was neck deep water in the houses. The roofs of the houses were broken because of the heavy trees being fallen upon them, and people had nothing to survive. They had nothing to eat. They have to sit at the top of their houses or at the roofs of their houses, and they were just surviving on raw coconuts. Okay, so this is what had happened when he has gone to Arsama, right? So write down next question. Describe the situation of Prashant when he suffered super cyclone at his friend's house. So what happened? When Prashant had gone to his friend's house, a super cyclone hit that area. It has not only devastated the houses, but it has also devastated the lives of the people, including Prashant. Prashant, who has already lost his mother, he was afraid that he may, God would not let him suffer from the same kind of bereavement that he has suffered some years ago when his mother was lost. So as the complete house, it was filled with water, he had to survive, or he had to go to the top of the house or to the roof of the house in order to save himself. And he has noticed that the brown sheet of water covered everything as far as his eye could see. There were animal carcasses, human corpses bloated with water, floating on the water, giving it a macabre scene. Okay, but even his tears, they were wiped out in rainwater. They had nothing to eat and they were just surviving on raw coconuts. Okay, and the same situation, it persisted for 2 days. And after 2 days, when there was decrease in the rainfall and the situation seemed to be a bit stabilized and the level of water was receding, he thought to go and seek out for his village, right? So till here, you have to note down the questions in your book only the textual questions you have to write in your notebooks. And then afterwards, what we will have tomorrow, I will continue with the extra questions of this chapter also, right? So that's all for today. And start writing, start making notebooks, as I'm going to check the notebooks side by side. Okay, so that's all for today.